Alarm system meant to protect you is costing police thousands of dollars in wasted resources. Brenda Lise Gonzalez spoke with Independence Police and is live in the newsroom with how they plan to deal with all these false alarms.
For every 10 alarm calls police respond to, 9 are false. They're afraid if they don't fix the problem, it could become a safety issue for officers. Cindy McLean depends on her alarm system.
It just gives me security that I know when I leave at night, I will get a call if something happens or somebody jiggles the doorknob, I will get a call.
Independence Police will also get the call if she doesn't respond to her alarm company. This year alone, out of the 2,098 alarm calls, more than 1,900 were false.
It's frustrating to officers.
Major John Cato says false alarms are a waste of time and manpower.
If you were to divide that and work it into an hours used to address this problem, this is a significant amount of money. It's a lot of man hours.
Around $300,000 a year. It's also a public safety concern for his officers.
When that alarm begins to be false always over and over, you're not ready for the actual alarm. It tends to be routine.
This week, he asked city council members to increase the fine for false alarms. Right now, alarm owners get 2 free passes. After that, they have to pay $25. The new fees would go up to $30, and after 10 false calls, $100. Plus, they'll stop responding to your alarm.
I know what labor costs. I mean, it's not a cheap entity, so I don't mind at all. I think that they probably need to do it.
She's been charged in the past for false alarms, but didn't mind paying it then and won't mind paying more now.
Yeah, I'm willing to pay it. I don't mind at all. I mean, it takes them away from doing something they ought to be doing. So for me, it's a small price to pay to know that my buildings are safe.
Cato says that false alarms are taking away resources from the more urban, less affluent parts of town where more burglaries occur and there are fewer alarms. City Council plans to discuss the proposed ordinance in a few months. Reporting live in the newsroom, Brenda Lise Gonzalez, 41 Action News.
Thanks, Brenda Lise. And this is an ongoing problem around the metro, including Kansas City, where they say 98% of the alarm calls are false. In KCMO, you need to be registered with police in order to get a response. And after 2 freebies, you get dinged with a $40 fine for every false alarm. Mm-mm.